I'm Kelly Cudney, and I'm a resource management officer here at Parks Canada. Today we're out here on the Rideau Canal looking at an aquatic invasive plant called European water chestnut. Water chestnut is an invasive species that can quickly take over lakes and rivers, outcompeting native plants and making water recreation difficult. So let's take a closer look at how to effectively remove this plant. So this is what water chestnut looks like once it's been pulled out of the water. It grows in a rosette and tends to have multiple rosettes, we call them, attached to a single stem. This is what the nut looks like attached to the roots at the base. They have very serrated leaves, and then later on in the summer, they do tend to develop small white flowers as well. If you've discovered the plant in smaller patches and you're hoping to remove them, here are some tips. Before heading out, make sure you have a stable vessel to work from and that you have the appropriate safety equipment, such as PFDs. When you're just starting out pulling water chestnut, you may want to wear long gloves because, as you can see here, the nuts that are found at the bottom of the stem, they can be quite sharp with multiple barbs on the nut, and it's very easy to puncture your skin. For smaller patches, hand pulling is very effective. So carefully lean over the side of the vessel and grab the plant as far down the stem as possible and gently pull it out. Ideally, the roots are pulled out as well in order to avoid regrowth, but sometimes the stem snaps off. Gently wiggling the stem with some upward pressure often helps to get the roots to dislodge. Dispose of the plants by bagging them and ensuring that they are not left or dumped near a water source. Do not leave them near the shore where they could re-enter the water. After removal, keep an eye on the area to ensure that plants don't return. Keep in mind that nuts can lay dormant for up to 12 years. If you're interested to join this effort, please contact the Environmental Services team of the Rideau Canal office or consider organizing a local removal event in your community. Removing water chestnut can be very labor intensive, but it's crucial for maintaining healthy and navigable waterways, so thank you for doing your part.